Hello and welcome to Cheshire Audio. Now today what I'm going to do is follow up on yesterday's Phonostages video and just go into a bit more detail about the stock I've got here for demonstration and a few others that I haven't actually got here, so I might just have to use pictures for that. I'll try and keep it upbeat. Obviously the news yesterday has knocked me for six a little bit, really. Obviously I never met the Queen. Did see her once be driven past in a car. Long time ago. I was heading to work up the M62 to Liverpool, and kept noticing every bridge as I was driving. There were police on it. Literally every bridge that crossed the motorway, there was police. Then realised that there was no cars coming in the opposite direction. And all of a sudden, just as I was approaching Liverpool, this big maroon Rolls Royce, the high top one that used to appear in quite regularly. Appeared over the brow of the hill and swept past with a couple of motorbikes and a couple of police cars behind it and gone. And very clearly saw the Queen sat there with somebody else who I never quite worked out who it was, but absolutely blew me away, to be honest. It was a weird experience on my way to work, but never forgot it, really. But that was my only actual experience of seeing the Queen. Obviously, been down to London a few times and seen the palace and all this sort of thing. Been to Holyrood and Windsor and all these sort of places. But not for six a bit, really. But I'll continue, hence doing a video, really, trying to take my mind off things. So yeah, let's talk about Phonostages. I'll turn the camera around and let's have a look. Okay, so I've just sort of assembled a few Phonostages that are sort of available to hand, really. Obviously, there are a few more, and I'll mention those as we go on. Starting point, obviously, is Project Phonobox MM, which is just their basic phono box. Like I said in the previous video, it's kind of for people who've got perhaps a mini system or just something that they haven't got phono capability on the system, and it's just a box to make it work. And it's a good little circuit. It works well. It's much better than the sort of cheap stuff you can get off eBay. It's a proper little phono stage for not a lot of money, really. Up from that, we've got the straight phono box, which gives you MC capability as well. Now, again, it's probably for people who've perhaps bought an older turntable that's got an MC cartridge on it and they haven't got MC capability. It's a get you going, but it's not a bad circuit for the money. We're up to about £100 there. It's sort of pretty good, really. Obviously not audiophile, but that's not really the name of the game with that one. It is a sort of make it work kind of scenario. Also then, at that sort of level, we've got little Riga Mini Phono A2D, ins and outs. It's also got an inbuilt digital side to it, so people buy these partly to use with a record player to amplifier, obviously, but also because you can actually record your music onto a hard drive or whatever off it. You can connect up to a computer and use Audacity to record your albums digitally. I must admit, a lot of people do that, but if I've ever sort of see them again and question them on it, very few people actually continue with it. They'll do a couple of albums and then decide it's too much hassle, because you have to record real time. You have to sit there, and Audacity should do the track breaks, but it's not actually that good at doing it. So most people get fed up and don't do it in the end. So I kind of ignore the USB on this. I don't think it's something that people really would use. I'm quite surprised with Riga that they did this, but I think it was just something that was an easy addition and it didn't affect the sound, so they put it on there. So anyway, it's there. When you get into the more serious stuff, we're then moving up to Riga Phono MM, which is their sort of more full-scale phono stage. We're up to over the £200 mark now. There's two versions of this, an MM version and an MC version. Obviously, this has still got the protective cover on the front, which is why it looks a bit weird. But this is the new sort of Mark V version of it, which has got the sort of casework that looks like the amplifiers. Nice clear circuit. Pretty good for the money, actually. It's difficult to beat this under sort of £350, really. You'd have to go to something like, and this is the next move, something like a little Black Cube Statement, which gives you a bit more clarity and a bit more definition. It's a very open sounding Phonostage, the Black Cube. It's quite a range of these. This is the Statement, which is sort of a bit, I think these are about 350 or so at the moment. I have to say this as of September 22, because prices are changing quite rapidly at the moment. Just a basic little, it's got, you know, MM and MC, a little bit of adjustment on there. I can't think what adjustment it does have, actually. Yeah, a little bit, a couple of loading options, and like I say, MC. Big, chunky. It's quite, I mean, I used to actually use at home the SE version of that, which was superb, and it was quite an expensive Phonostage at the time, really. Still going, the whole range is quite, there's about six models, I think, in the range now. And then we've got the, next up is the Atoll, which is about, what are these now, about 390. Magnet and coil, a little bit of gain adjustment on it. Again, nice, clean and clear, fairly, you know, fairly easygoing sort of Phonostage. These work with most things. I've used this quite a bit in the demo room. We had it running with the P8 with an Anya on it, and it was really good combination. It sounded really good with it, actually. So that's quite a good value, actually, that, because it's when you look at the construction of it, there's an awful lot going on in there, and it does work well. Up from there we go to, it's quite a big jump now of what from what's here. Jump to exposure. Now between the Atoll and the exposure, I haven't actually got one in at the moment because there had been, I don't know whether there still is, a bit of a supply issue. And that's the tricord dyno. The tricords, like I said, I'll stick a picture up here of one. Upgradable with power supplies. There's also the Diablo. I don't tend to do the Diablo so much. I think the dyno and the dyno with power supply is a really good buy. But like I said, a bit difficult to get at the moment. The other one I've forgotten is also I do Rothwell. So there's the Simplex and the Rialto, which kind of are around and about the price of the Atoll. Exposure is about 850 now. Quite a lot more sort of load settings, gain settings on this than we've had before. Very, very precise sounding Phonostage, the Exposure. Loads of spaciousness in the sound and everything. It's a really good circuit, this, actually. Really like it. Surprised they don't do anything more high-end than that, to be honest, unless they do and I've just missed it. And sort of sitting either side of that price-wise, we've got the Tom Evans Microgroove. This is a basic Microgroove, which is about 600. There's a Microgroove Plus, which is about 1,000, which has a much beefier power supply than this. A few internal mods, I think, as well. But all the Tom Evans designs, I mean, they go from this one right up to, well, there's the, so you go Microgroove, Microgroove Plus, Groove Plus. Then we go, I think it's straight to Mastergroove. Mastergroove after that, which is the price of a Volkswagen Golf. It's, you know, you're getting into really serious stuff there. But they're incredible. They're all very, very clear, very, very open and three-dimensional sounding. All a little bit fussy of source, though. They all need good equipment with them, really, or they just tend to show you the inadequacies of your setup a little bit. They're almost too good in some situations. Beyond Tom Evans in the range at the moment, probably one of the best all-rounders, I think, Rieger Aria. And that's, I've reviewed this before, but it kind of gives you everything you want, really. There's quite a lot of adjustment on it. You've got quite a decent selection of gain settings, decent load settings on it, so you can match it to anything you want. The Tom Evans gives you a bit of gain, but the loading is set at the factory. So it's not quite as straightforward as some, but the Rieger, it gives you everything you would ever need, really. It's got more loads, more gain settings on it than pretty much everything else, I think, really. But yeah, it's nice and open, it's clear, clean and clear. It's got a nice warmth to it and a naturalness to it. And it, like I think I said on my review of this, it took me by surprise because quite often manufacturers who do other things aren't that good at tend not to be that good at Phonostages because it is a bit of a different, it's a different thing. It's not like making an amplifier. It seems to be a bit more of a black art. It's a bit more sort of having to understand noise and all this sort of thing at a much finer level, really, than you do with that straight amplifiers. And there's only certain companies that seem to be very good at it, particularly people like Tom Evans. There's Graham Slee, there's a few, Graham at Tricord, there's a few people like that who are just particularly good at Phonostages. and that's the main thing that they do. So that's just a like broad talk through what's here, what's available for demonstration. Obviously, the other things out there as well that we can deal with, but these are the sort of mainstay of my sort of loan stock. If you ever want to try anything out, so that's it. Yeah, I'll just turn the camera around. Hope that was of interest. A little bit haphazard, as usual. But yeah, I just thought to show the, because I've got quite a lot of Phonostages on demonstration, really, and you know, I just thought it'd be worth talking through pluses and minuses of some of them. I'll probably try. I might not just at the moment, but I might do a sort of much closer comparison. I'll talk through some of the other models, really. I mean, some of these I've actually done individual reviews. I've done the Tom Evans. I've done the Aria, I think. I haven't done the Atoll yet. I haven't listened to an awful lot to the Atoll, but the initial impressions of that have been good on it, really. So I need to give it a bit more of a listen, just to get a proper formulated idea of that, really. Obviously, the Lehman I know, because I've owned them in the past. Exposure always made decent Phonostages. But anyway, I'll think of some other Phonostage-y things to do at some point, because I do get a lot of questions about them. I will be doing a video in a minute, actually, which I'm going to try and work out how you can get something to launch in a few days. But I've got quite exciting news. Well, I'm excited anyway. There's a product range that has been unavailable for absolutely no... Well, there's been various explanations to why it's been unavailable for over 2 years. And it's been a bit of a major problem for them, because it was a good selling range, and all of a sudden I couldn't get it anymore, and nobody in the UK has had it. Interestingly, some other countries seem to have stock, but then we were getting stories back saying can't make them, can't do this, can't whatever, and it was every explanation we got was different. I can't actually say anything just yet, but I'm going to record the video, because there's a launch happening. A good friend of mine has picked up the agency and is bring it into the UK, and apparently there's no problems with stock. So what was all the things we've been told over the past couple of years don't make any sense anymore. So anyway, but that'll be an announcement that I probably try and get it to hit Monday, Tuesday, something like that. Thanks for watching. I'm trying to be mysterious and exciting now, but it's not really working, is it? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give a subscribe and a like, and I will see you in a future video. Thank you very much, in a couple of days. Thank you.